Hey guys, it's Mackenzie. Welcome back to my channel. So today I have yet another cumulative thrift haul. These are my finds from last week. I went to both the Goodwill outlet, otherwise known as the Goodwill bins, where I paid $2.19 per pound here in Houston, as well as the Family Thrift Center outlet, where I paid $2 per item. So everything you will see here, I picked up at one of those two places. I paid, you know, $1.50 to $2 per item, and I have about 50 items here. So let's go ahead and get started. We have one pair of shoes, a couple accessories, and then the rest is clothing. So our only pair of shoes are these Lucky Brand suede stacked heel wedge booties. A great neutral color, an everyday shoe for fall time. These are size 8. They are the Yimmy style, and they look like they're in great shape. This is definitely the time to source and list boots. People are going crazy for boots, sweaters, outerwear this time of year, just trying to transition their wardrobes. One belt. This caught my eye because it looked like it was really nice quality, and it is genuine leather. I also just really liked this whole like boho medallion detail, and yeah, the quality was there. It has no brand name, no tags, no size, so I'll just measure, but with the kind of braided design, it's pretty much fully adjustable. And one's a bra and one's a swimsuit top. This swimsuit top is from Torrid, and I was really excited to find it in a bin. This is the type of piece that you will have an amazing ROI or return on investment with. I probably paid about 75 cents for it, and I'll sell it for probably $28 to $35. It has a lot going for it. It's super strappy, and it's in great shape. Doesn't look like it was really ever worn. It's a size 2R, so I'll have to look. That just sounds like a 2X regular, but I'll have to confirm that. There is the Torrid tag, and the straps can kind of be moved around to be kind of adjustable. And then one little sports bra from Nike. Again, probably paid less than a dollar for this. I can sell it for around 18 to 20. It still has the pads, which is great. It's a size medium, I believe. It has a mesh back. Well, I'm not seeing, but yeah, Nike dry fit size medium. Okay, moving into clothing. More Torrid. This is an amazing piece. 2X leopard print cardigan. I just sold an altered state cardigan like this, and it was very popular. It had lots of likes and comments. It does have pockets, it's long line. It has this like furry exterior. And again, this looks like it's in excellent shape. So very solid pickup, lots of kind of sellable factors to this. We have Free People. It's like a brown knit sweater, and it has a frayed trim. There we go. And then it does have kind of like the exposed seam look. So this is the back shoulder. You see the exposed seams. It's a size small. It's pretty oversized though. I love the kind of, I love the brown color because brown is definitely trending. I think the whole Kardashians have kind of made it popular. So this is 65% wool, 11% linen. So great natural fabrics going on with that. Madewell. I'm extremely picky with Madewell these days, even with picking it up at a very low cost of goods, size medium, just because, you know, it's kind of pointless to list it and have it sit for a long time, even if, you know, your cost of goods are low. But this piece I did want to get. It's called the Central Shirt, which is a very popular style of shirt from Madewell. It sells really well in the $25 to $35 range. It has a stripe to it, and it's just kind of like that laid back, easy kind of throw on top, but you know, you still look put together. So I can see definitely why people would like it. This is from spring of 2018, and it's in really good shape. We have a Zara dress, really pretty. I loved this lace design around the chest and the waist. The sleeves are sheer with this really pretty dainty floral print, and then it is more of a mini length. So this, you know, you could wear with sandals in the warmer weather, or you could pair it with booties in the fall time, size medium. This was a very exciting find. This is a brand, I believe I've only sold it once, and it sold very quickly for $85. It brought a ton of traffic to my closet. The brand is Sezane, S-E-Z-A-N-E. It's written kind of small right here is the brand, size medium. Let me see, it might have a better, yeah, here's a better view of the brand on the inner tag. Definitely a brand to be on the lookout for. This top will probably sell for $50 to $80. I need to do a little bit more research. It's a striped knit top with a scallop hemline and then a scalloped flyaway back. Super cute. And I love the kind of orangey stripe to this. Again, a great fall time kind of staple top with a little bit of flare with the scallop hem. This is a really pretty piece. I just kind of found it in a bin, and at first I almost didn't even mess with it because I could tell that it was 100% silk and it's a maxi length gown. And so I knew that it was just kind of inevitable for it to have some flaws, some runs to the silk, staining, but I could not find one flaw on this dress. And I looked at it for, probably 10 minutes in the store. So I think maybe someone bought it to wear to a wedding or some type of event and then just never got around to wearing it. But it's 100% silk. It is fully lined, floor length, really, really beautiful kind of chest area with the sheer silk portion. And then the kind of like, it's just really pretty. The brand is Mango and it has a little keyhole opening and back, and then it zips down. And again, it is floor length. Let me show you the tag. It's Mango Suit, so I think that means that it is their more formal kind of line. Well, not seeing the tag. Oh, here it is. So yeah, Mango Suit, and it's a size 6. Really, really pretty dress here. And again, I was so excited to see that it really had no flaws. I think this would be a great kind of event dress for someone. I will add lots of keywords to that: cocktail, formal, gown, prom, wedding, bridesmaid, all kinds of keywords. This was a more fun pickup, vintage sweater, and this kind of stuff sells incredibly well for me. It's one of a kind, it's fun, it's funky, it's very high quality. The brand is Lairds of Scotland, made in Great Britain, finest quality woolens. And the fabric makeup is 78% mohair, 13% wool, 9% nylon. So mohair is definitely more of a luxurious fabric. I did model this just to kind of show just how trendy it can be. I think that should help it sell pretty quick. I love the kind of funky 80s color block that has happening. We have blue and gray and size extra small. And this is a turtleneck poncho, and it's actually made up of their signature soft fabric. I've mentioned it so many times. That is a key word, signature soft. It's all one word. It is exclusive to the Lou and Gray line from Ann Taylor. So Ann Taylor is the umbrella brand of Lou and Gray. Lou and Gray is Ann Taylor's like loungewear kind of line. And within Lou and Gray, they have a fabric blend called Signature Soft Fabric. And people definitely search for it because it is incredibly soft. I mean, this feels like butter. It is typically rayon and spandex. I mean, it's always rayon and spandex. That is kind of, I think someone cut the tag out. Yeah, someone cut the tag out, but this should sell really well just because it's a great kind of practical item, but it's comfy, cozy. More Free People, striped, oversized, raw hem, very true to the Free People brand. It's got that kind of asymmetric, almost jagged hemline. I love the colors on this. It's like a tan and navy. Definitely my kind of color palette. This is the We The Free line, size extra small, small. But honestly, this would probably fit up to a large. Super cute. And the stripes kind of switch up at the sleeves. We have a frame silk blouse. This is another brand to definitely keep your eye out for. Be on the lookout for, size extra small. This is 100% silk. It has a ruffle collar and then a bell sleeve with a little tie at the sleeve. This did have one small flaw at the shoulder, I think. Yeah, it just has like a tiny little, I'm not even sure what it is, but maybe, I'm not sure. Is it like a tiny run? I forget, but I did note it. But yeah, it's just kind of like a little pick in the fabric. So I did note that. And I did actually see that in the store, but the fact that the entire body of the blouse was in perfect condition, no stains, no runs, I did still pick this up, especially, you know, at that $2 price. Did I show the back? The back has a little keyhole opening. I really, really liked this kind of ruffle collar trim. This is a men's item. I have no idea the brand. Agave Luxe, size medium. But, is that focusing? There we go. But it was 100% merino wool and I couldn't find any flaws. So again, going into the colder weather, I do want to stock up on sweaters, both in my women's and a men's closet. I love selling over in my men's closet. Honestly, I just kind of list stuff. I will share occasionally, but I just kind of list stuff and forget it. And then I will just kind of, every once in a while, get either a very fair offer on something or it will just be purchased outright. So it's super easy kind of listing and selling over in my men's closet. Next, we have this Athleta sleeveless top. It's a tunic top. It has these side vents here and it's kind of like a loose knit at the shoulders. This is a size large, I believe. Size large, yeah. And then the loose knit carries over to the back. So this is the older tag, Athleta. It's this kind of thin gray tag, but I did still want to pick this up because it is a size large, it's long line, and it's kind of a versatile piece. You know, you could dress this up or down, and it's tunic length, so I think it will still sell pretty well. Next we have Citizens of Humanity jean shorts. They have a button fly. They have the manufactured whiskering and fading. And some people specifically look for this kind of longer length of short. And so I do like to have it in my closet. These are a size 26 and these are in excellent condition. Just a fun Banty. We all love Maroon 5. I love finding and selling Bantys. They are definitely a bread and butter staple in my closet. And this one was in really great shape. No kind of fading or wear to it. It's on an American Apparel tee, size medium. Another men's item. This is definitely a solid pickup. This was a bins find. It's Robert Graham, which has a very high retail price, and it's a size 3XL, which is great. Classic fit. This is a short sleeve button down top. I would have loved to list this going into summertime, but it's fine. It will still sell. And it has kind of like this very faint embossed texture throughout the top. I believe it's showing there. And then the sleeves, you can kind of turn them over to show this floral print if you'd like. It kind of matches the collar area. And the more kind of classic shirts from Robert Graham are long sleeves, long sleeve button downs that have the kind of flip wrist cuff that are vibrant, kind of like this, you know, contrasting floral print. And so I think that's the most kind of popular style, but I definitely think this will still sell, especially with having, you know, no stains, no spots, no signs of wear, size 3XL. I think that's still definitely a solid piece. These are, I just grabbed these. They were sitting on top of a bin. They are vintage Lee shorts, very high-waisted and cheeky, but honestly, this kind of stuff is very trendy. High-waisted kind of older shorts have always sold extremely well for me. They have no size, but I think they fit like a 23, 24-ish. More Free People. This dress didn't have, it was missing the brand tag, but something about it on the rack just kind of screamed Free People to me. I think it was the sleeve. It's like a bubble sleeve, and then it has a cold shoulder. This is the front. It has like the kind of choker neckline, and then just a really fun, it's almost like a marbled print. It's a mini length, and then the back has a keyhole opening. I have no idea what size this would be. It looks maybe like a medium large, so I will measure that. And the way that I did check the interior fabric tag, and I'm just very familiar with Free People tags. I could tell that this was Free People based on this tag here. It also does have the 66170 RN number, which is for Free People, Anthropologie, and Urban Outfitters, but I could tell that this was not an Anthro or Urban tag, so that just left Free People. And I have found the stock photo for it, so it has been confirmed. Next, we have Banana Republic, size large. I thought this would just be an excellent closet staple. It's a black, crew neck sweater. It's long line. This has like no signs of wear, and it has like a mixed knit on the sides as well as a side vent at the bottom hem. And the fact that this had no pilling when it was a 31% wool, 10% alpaca blend sweater told me that it really hasn't been worn much. It's in great shape. And you know, that's a great fabric makeup. Alpaca, wool, they're all keywords. Next we have a Zara top, super pretty. It's like a smocked upper, which is off shoulder. And it has a little tie here, which the stock photo shows it tied into a bow just kind of in the front. But when I modeled it, I didn't know what to do with this tie, so I just tied it around my neck, and I kind of liked the way that looked. But I did get this because it's 100% linen. I loved these sleeves, like bell sleeves. And again, I thought it was just a nice little closet staple. It's a size small. And also, this is the newer Zara tag, which I do love to find and pick up. Okay, this was just another kind of fun grab. I thought it would be a nice bundling piece. It's Tahari, which I've talked about Tahari before. I don't pick up the diffusion lines like Tea by Tahari. I forget the other ones, but I usually will only pick up this label if it's in combination with a good fabric, which this is not like wool or alpaca or anything, but I loved the print and the mock neck on this. So that was reason enough for me to get it. It also is a size large. Great shape. I thought it was just super nice, contemporary, kind of minimalist look. It's super soft. Let me see what fabric it is. I just remember checking and viscose, polyester, and nylon. So I was a little bit on the fence about that, but you know, the print, the size, the condition, they were enough to persuade me. Soft surroundings. This is a size extra small, or small slash medium, which I really only like to pick large and up sizing in soft surroundings. But I did like this vest, and you know, a larger size could wear this because it really has like not much shape to it. It's a really nice little layering piece. You could wear you know, really any type of top and just layer this over top to kind of make it a little bit more fun, boho. It's like a bandana print. This is a men's piece, which I didn't know when I grabbed it, but you know, I still would have. It's Zara, and I looked it up last night. I think it's called like the linen overshirt. Yeah. This is the tag, once again, that newer tag, which we love to see, size medium. The outer is 100% linen and the lining is cotton. So breathable materials. I loved the buttons. It has two pockets in front. I mean, you know, obviously a woman could totally wear this. It's definitely like a shacket. So I will be putting shacket as a keyword that is otherwise known as a shirt jacket, and they are definitely going to be very popular again this fall and winter time. Next, we have a vintage piece, which are always some of my favorites. I got this because it reminded me of a Kuji sweater. How cool is this? I love the mixed knits and colors. Grandpa style cardigan sweaters sell so well for me in the winter time. Again, another solid bread and butter pickup for me. I usually try to model them just to, you know, try to show how oversized they are, how trendy they can look, and just to give the buyer a better idea of fit, style. We the Free by Free People ruffle hem top, super wide neckline. You could definitely wear this like off shoulder and slouchy. Super cute distressed edges, and this is a size small. This is J. Crew size 12, 100% silk printed button down top. So again, several sellable factors to this top. You have this fun novelty like pocket watch print, really cute. It's a great kind of basic color, navy. You could wear this with dark jeans. Size 12, excellent size, and it is more of a luxurious fabric being 100% silk. This is from fall of 2014. But it's in great shape, so yeah, super excited for this. We have a pair of Anthropology Cartonnier velvet kind of Baroque or jacquard pants, Charlie Ankle. These are a size 0. I like the teal color. And this style of pant has always sold pretty well for me, the Charlie Skinny. I think people like it because it's kind of versatile. Again, you could kind of dress that up or down. Just a closet staple here, Eileen Fisher, size medium. This is a boat neck. Is that boat neck? Yeah, I believe it's a boat neck sweater top. It's like in between sweater and top. Excellent condition, super soft. This is, let me see. I know it's definitely a wool blend. Yeah, 53% organic cotton, 35% virgin wool and nylon. So excellent fabric makeup. A super fun piece here, Wild Fox graphic sweater or sweatshirt. Actually, I think they call these jumpers, baggy beach jumpers. It has a tiger print, it says tender, and then this is just a plain back. This is a size large, super soft interior. Just a little fun pickup here. No idea on the brand with this. Just says Ultimate Cycle Products, made in USA. But it was incredibly lightweight. I probably paid about 50 cents for this at the bins. And it's a little lace-up top. Even if I sell this for $10, $15, I mean, that's a great return. We have a Patagonia size medium large striped poncho. Did that show? I think we all know what Patagonia looks like at this point, but a really fun poncho. I love the kind of color scheme going on, and two little pockets. And then down here at the bottom, it has veil embroidered, which I believe this is a place or some type of, I forget, but it's not like someone didn't do this themselves. Patagonia did it, I believe. So that is better than it being like a custom embroidery. Next we have Free People button fly high-waisted distressed jeans with the raw hem. Very trendy cut of jean with everything happening here. These are a size 25 regular, and I don't think you're going to be able, well, yeah, you can kind of see it says We the Free there. Super cute. Just a cute little vintage plaid kind of schoolgirl style dress. These have always sold great for me, right in that $20 to $25 range. Zips and back. I will put keywords again like clueless, plaid, schoolgirl, preppy. It almost has like a houndstooth print. So this is another vintage one-of-a-kind little pickup. I think this will sell super quickly. How adorable is this with the embroidered cherry print? And wearing cardigans as tops has been pretty trendy, or it was trendy last fall and winter time. So the brand on this is Twiggy. It's 74% lamb's wool, 15% rabbit hair and nylon. So the fabric blend as well as the cut and this little embroidery, I think, are all super sellable factors. I grabbed this based on style, Hinge, which is just a Nordstrom house brand, size small, but I kid you not, I think I've sold Hinge 2 or 3 times in the past. I've always picked the pieces up based on style, and they have always sold same day. So hopefully we continue that trend with this. I thought this was adorable with the purple and this kind of like textured knit on the bottom portion. carries over to the sleeves. And this is 30% wool, so a nice solid sweater there. These were a great find. Someone was just tossing them around in a bin and I happened to see this tag and my alarm bells went off. So they're light wash, high-waisted, frayed hem, Alexander Wang shorts. Super great find. They're called the Bite High-Rise Shorts in a size 28. And those probably retailed for around $200. So, and that's the second time that I've recently found Alexander Wang at the bins. So hopefully I find some more. More newer tags, Zara. I absolutely love this sweater. It's a size small and it's like a color block, chunky knit. It's like super soft and fuzzy. You can see that it definitely has like a fuzzy texture to it. I love the color palette. It's like neutrals, but you know, you still have a little bit of color happening. And this looks like it was never worn. It has no signs of wear, no pilling whatsoever. And I believe this was also a wool blend. Yes, 19% wool. So great pickup there. Blue and gray, I've actually sold this sweater before. It's a size small, and it's like a pastel plaid print. Again, just trying to stock up on some basic sweaters. This is a great bundle item, and it is actually 3% alpaca and 6% wool, so. Okay, I don't think I've ever sold this brand before, but it's Boss by Hugo Boss, and it's a really nice kind of contemporary dress. It has like faint pinstripes up top and then kind of bolder pinstripes on the kind of pencil skirt region. It has button tabs, so you could, you know, fold the sleeves and wear it with a cuff or just wear it long sleeve. I'm not sure what I will list this for yet, just because I've never sold it before, but I'm thinking maybe 75-ish. It's called the Dunka dress, and it doesn't have 6 petite in US. So, yeah, pretty excited for this. It's in excellent shape. Oh, this was another great find. So this is Smart Wool. It's a men's item. It's size medium. Definitely a brand to be on the lookout for, especially if the piece has no holes or flaws. Their items are usually 100% merino wool. It's like a fine merino wool, and so it is susceptible to holes, but I could not find any flaws on this long sleeve, so that's great. I can probably sell this for, I would say, 38 to 50-ish. Let me just double check that I'm not, yeah, 100% merino wool, so. Great kind of layering piece. You know, you could wear that as like a base layer and then something over top if it's really cold outside. Free People, size small. Crossover, kind of faux wrap, surplice sweater. Super cute to layer with. I love the oversized fit and these sleeves. And again, great fabric. 13% wool, 7% mohair, as well as alpaca. Paige jeans, size 24. I don't always pick up Paige, but these were in excellent shape. And you know, going into fall time and the new year, I think these will sell at some point. They're like a coated metallic. And actually, I was looking at comps for these, and they have sold several times in the past for, I believe, around $40 to $75, and there weren't too many available, so that's always good to see. This is just a basic, kind of essential sweater. It's from Nordstrom. Nordstrom Signature. It's 100% cashmere. It's a size extra small. And you know, anything 100% cashmere that's in great shape, I will grab. It's a V-neck. I did model this once again just to kind of show the fit. It's a V-neck with like a ribbed construction, and then I loved this little bell sleeve. It's just a subtle bell sleeve, so you know, just adds a little bit of flair to a basic sweater. So it's just a bins grab. It's out from under from Urban Outfitters. This is a house brand from them, size small. It's like a waffle knit striped oversized top, super slouchy, and I mean, this thing is huge. You could wear this off the shoulder. You could even, you know, wear a tank underneath and just unbutton the front. More Zara. I love the kind of contemporary cut of this sweater. Zara Knit, which this line from Zara specifically, Zara Knit, sells really well for me. Size medium. It's like a ribbed, well, I guess the entire sweater is ribbed, and it has a turtleneck. Again, just a very oversized, slouchy kind of body, and then tie bottom with wide sleeves. This is just H&M, but it's a size large, and I liked this color. I thought it would be maybe a nice holiday sweater, and it was, I think, mohair. 32% mohair and 32% wool. So, had to get that. Coming down to our last couple pieces here. This is a men's Nike windbreaker zip jacket. It has zip pockets. The sleeves are like a contrasting print. It has a hood. It's vented in the back here. And this is a size, I think. Let me see. Yeah, extra large. So great pickup here. This will go straight to my men's closet. Tory Burch turtleneck sweater. Just a basic turtleneck sweater. I saw this little kind of logo plate at the bottom, and this is a sign of something being designer, just because cheaper brands won't take the time or, you know, extra cost to add logo tags to their pieces, especially like little metal logo tags. Tory Burch, size medium. And this again, I think it's merino wool. Yeah, 85% merino wool, but it does have spandex, so it's stretchy. And lastly, we have these overalls from Abercrombie and Fitch. Just kind of a bread and butter bundle piece. They're a medium wash. They have whiskering, a rolled bottom hem with some fraying. They were in excellent shape. I actually just thrifted a pair exactly like these in my size. These are size medium, and I have worn them several times recently. So is that it? Yeah, that's it for this haul. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed. As always, I will try to have all of these pieces listed in my closet by the time that this thrift haul goes up. So if you guys want to see, you know, what I price anything for, or if you're interested in anything, I will leave the link for my closet in the description down below. Thank you guys once again so much for watching, and I will see y'all soon. Bye y'all.